Hi, I'm Chris. I'm a combat vet. I'm old. I'm playing airsoft for fun and skills training. I make these videos to review my tactics and disseminate information. Welcome to season 2 of Marine Plays Airsoft. Match just started and we're already in the middle room. Now, in CQB, in confined places, you want to, how do I explain this? In CQB, at a T-shaped intersection, you want to take the opposing corners, like in this illustration. That's how Dylan and I are set up right now. Dylan just got shot, so I know someone's to my right. Now this guy's picking up a shallower version of Dylan's old angle, and I'm about to button hook. The idea behind a button hook is you're popping around a corner and shooting the other person to death, if there is a person there. In airsoft, it usually results in a trade. That means in real life, if you button hook, it will result in a trade. You'll both get shot. That's something to keep in mind. In real life, that means you die. So I dug that corner. Now I'm watching this side. I don't know why, I think I was expecting the enemy to hit him and rush through, and that I would be able to shoot them in the side. Dylan is about to respawn and show up at my side, so that's my signal to flow forward. And you'll see,
moving up,
we flow pretty far forward, past the middle of the map, pretty close to their spawn. That's their spawn up there to the left. Now, I'm moving forward, so the guys behind me are probably flowing forward a little as well. I shot both of those guys before either of them shot me. One of them didn't call their hit for a minute. It was kind of delayed. That kind of thing happens. A lot's going on. We see someone and we shoot at them, then realize that we got shot too. So again, we have it's a T-shaped.
One close over here.
A T-shaped structure.
I'm gonna pop this.
And I button hook it. In real life, and in airsoft, it's better to just peek that corner in little sections, unless you want to trade, which means that you both die. I think I got both. So I'm holding this, is kind of boring, so I fast forward. Yeah, these little slivers are clear, so I decide to cross that open area and try to get behind cover. But the cover is very small. That part of the map is set up very well.
Coming out.
I'm really liking having this M4. I haven't run around and done force on force with an M4 since probably for 10 or 15 years since I was in the military. So this was actually a lot of fun for me as a vet to run around with an actual rifle. We're not clearing that stuff very well. We're just moving real fast to get past the middle of the map. Poor Dylan. I wanted to bump up past him to his left so that we could envelop around. He's really putting in work here. And as soon as I passed through there, I got shot in the leg from somewhere. It was very obvious. Very obviously, I got shot. I know there's a guy up here behind a barricade to the left. Started to realize my gun is overhopped, so the BBs are getting to him, and then as soon as they get to him, they're going up over his head. So I moved forward a little bit, but he got me fair and square. I noticed something here though. While I was reviewing this footage, I noticed that I'm pretty sure he shot me. Boom. See that? I think it hit the magazine and bounced, but I noticed that while I was reviewing the footage. So I just respawned here. I'm kind of hanging back because I suspect that that guy is up there. So I'm very cautiously moving forward. I'm shooting the walls so that any players up there that are scared, I'm hoping that they'll run off, because players do that. That little crack is clear. Someone just flashed their light. The right is not clear. I don't know if someone's hiding in the corner. They're not. So there's someone on the right with a flashlight. And he got me. That was Gabe. Gabezilla. I'll link his channel in the description below. His videos are like primo. Here we go. I think Gabe is up there, so I'm moving up slowly. If there are friendly players ahead of me, then it's probably clear. He just died. That's a teammate, so it's probably clear up to here. I'm thinking about what to do, and this guy just rushes forward, so when your team moves up, you move up. I decide to move up a little bit more. I pop out, there's a player. He's behind the barricade, so I shoot at him while moving. And I happen to hit him. This is pretty much the end of the match. I don't see anyone for the rest of this footage. So this is my recap. Main things that stuck out to me from this footage are, not everyone's gonna call their hits immediately. Sometimes it's gonna be significantly delayed, because that's just how brains work sometimes. It's not always intentional. And again, I'm guilty of that too. Other than that, I need to, I should practice peeking, because button hooks in real life will get me shot just as much as button hooks in airsoft will get me shot.